Well, rock and surf fishing is there's quite a few elements that can help you succeed when you go out on a fishing trip. One of them is obviously fishing with good tackle. The other is having nice fresh bait at times. And also one of the key factors is a little bit of water reading. On the beaches there's so much of the same sort of formation and the same long stretches of white sand. Sometimes helps just to pick the right water and put you in the best position to get bites. And today what I'm gonna do is I'm looking for the deepest part of the water on this beach. And in front of me here there's like a hole, as we'll call it. It's quite a deep section, but on the side of it there's breaking banks. And what that does is it creates an environment where the water rushes over those sandbanks and drains out of those holes. So it creates an area where there's a bit of rip current to take that smell out, and it creates a bit of turn in the water just to generate a nice feeding area. So we've got quite a good zone here, decent water. Let's put this Mackie in and see if we can get a bite. Wasn't long at all. Literally hit the water, came back, tightened up a little bit, and seems like a fish is starting to feed a bit now on the dropping tide. Oh, hello. Thought it might have been something different, but it feels just like one of those diamond rays again. Ooh. Maybe something with a little bit more attitude. Quite amazing. When you first got here, we waited quite a while for the bite. But I think with the smell, cast after cast, generating that bit of a chum line, these fish have started moving towards the area where we're throwing our bait. And seem to be finding the bait quite quickly now. Always a bonus. Well, that's quite interesting. I was just talking about how these diamonds aren't really great fighters, and and then you get one that has a little bit of stamina in it, and it drags you 300 meters down the beach. This one's a lot bigger, probably looking at about 60, 65 kilos. And yeah, it definitely just glided with the current, and made its way down the beach. But as I was pulling the fish up, my hook came out, so it was an easy tactical release. And yeah, it looks like we're fishing in a bit of a diamond hole there. Diamond skates everywhere. Oh. Even though we're catching the same species of fish, it's always good to be getting a bite. And especially these fish take a bit of line, nice and strong. Lovely to see those fish swim away nicely. You keep them right by the water's edge and just let the water wash over them. Don't put them on the dry sand. Keep them upright, and just respecting our fishing grounds, respecting the bites we get, and hopefully it carries on that way. We just have a look here at my finger. That fish's mouth, it's very hard, but inside, if you look at it carefully, it's all teeth. And if they're all pointing backwards, tiny little teeth, and grabbing that fish by the mouth to release it, it's taking all the skin off my finger. So gotta be a little bit careful of that, but you make sure that you don't grab it in the holes on the top of the fish. It's very bad for them. But rather take a little cut to the hand than do any damage to the fish. Nice when the fish are biting.
Pen, let the battle begin.